Michelle Kennedy is working from home. Mm-hmm. Michelle, what can we look forward to this upcoming week?
Well, we are looking forward to more humid weather for sure and good rain chances, but we also have a new tropical system out there that we have been monitoring. This is Tropical Depression number one. I want to show you exactly what's going to happen with this system. We've got rain out to the west. That's going to come our way, but one is going to become Tropical Storm Arthur, and we're looking at that as we continue into the next 24 hours. It's already lifting off the coast of Florida. By tomorrow afternoon, it's going to become a tropical storm named Arthur, we believe, and it's going to scoot up along the South Carolina coastline. Then by Monday, it's already rolling up along our coast in North Carolina. It could impact folks in Cape Hatteras more directly, either by touching off nearby or possibly a tropical storm landfall. So we're going to be watching for that. And you can see as it scoots to the northern east a little later into Tuesday, we'll see it pull away from the northeast as well. So our temperatures in the water right now are in the upper 60s and low 70s there. We have 80s though, where it has formed from the Gulf and into the Bahamas and now off the coast of Florida, rather. So you're going to see those showers, those thunderstorms for us impacted mainly by an upper low that comes in. And this is going to stay along the North Carolina coast. And we're believing that Arthur, of course, will become that name system tomorrow. It's Tropical Depression number one. It's going to bring the clouds, the heavy surf for you into Sunday. As we go into the next couple of days, likely some high rip current risks, so we could expect to see those red flags flying at the beaches. And then a possible approach near the Outer Banks, near the Cape Hatteras area. It's about 355 miles away from Wilmington right now in the Wrightsville Beach area. So we're looking at this system well off the coast and likely to stay off the coast. What's not going to stay away from us will be the system to the west. It's coming in from areas of Texas, the Midwest. We've got a couple of fronts that are just draped across the north of us and creating some showers and thunderstorms the farther north we go into Virginia. But for us right now, you're at 84 degrees in Greensboro. We have 83 in Asheboro, and these temperatures are really warm combined with some higher humidity. Dew points in the upper 50s, but those showers and those thunderstorms for us forming thanks to a front that we get you into Monday with. And a lot of surface moisture is going to keep us rather muggy, unfortunately, as we talk about rain chances. So winds out of the east and southeast at about 5 to 10 miles an hour. Your dew points tomorrow into the 60s, and looks like it's going to be just a touch even more humid than today. And we'll see those shower chances developing the later we go through the afternoon on Sunday. So our highs in the low 80s Sunday afternoon, with an isolated storm or two. Most folks, though, don't see the rain until we hit Monday, and that's going to be a little later in the day Monday. We expect some showers possibly early midday in the mountains and then late afternoon, evening for folks in the Triad and foothills. Look at this. Maximum temperatures today, pretty good. 87 degrees in Greensboro. We actually officially made it to 86 in Winston-Salem and Greensboro at PTI Airport. We are typically 77 this time of the year. Instead, nice, about a 10 degree temperature bump out there. We have 63 degrees tomorrow morning for you with some clouds hanging in there. A few more clouds by late tomorrow with 84 and that rain chance at 20%. 60 degrees in the foothills will take you all the way to 82. Yeah, by middle of the day, we're already in those 70s, and in the mountains, you're going to have more clouds. An isolated storm is possible, more likely as we get you into late afternoon, even if you have anything at all and you're near 74 degrees tomorrow. Your rain chances, they're high over the next several days. We may see some 1 to 4 inches of rain as we get you into the next few days. You can see the 7-day forecast shows you from 84 degrees to near 80 on our Monday impact day straight through Thursday, and a little bit cooler to seasonable toward the end of next week.